This is a demonstration of static and kinetic friction. I've got here a string and a cart, which can move pretty much without friction along this track when I put it wheels down. When I put it wheels up, it has a fair amount of friction moving along the track and will help me to demonstrate static friction, which is if you hang a mass on the end of this string, this is a 20 gram mass, and the force of gravity acting on this mass is its mass, 20 grams, times the acceleration of gravity, 9.8 meters per second squared. Convert grams to kilograms, multiply by 9.8, and it gives you the force of gravity acting down on this mass. Because the string is stationary and this mass is not accelerating, the tension that pulls up on the mass must equal the weight, its own weight pulling it down. So that tension, we can work it out, just multiply the numbers, and the tension translates over into a tension force on this cart. So the tension in the rope pulls the cart in this direction. There's a gravitational force, the mass of the cart, times the acceleration of gravity pulling it down, and then a normal force up on the cart as well. But what's balancing the tension in the string that's pulling the cart this way? The answer is the static friction force, which operates in the opposite direction. And that's a rule of thumb, and sometimes it can be a little bit tricky to determine the direction of the static friction force. The fail-safe way to figure out what direction it acts is to say, what direction would this move in were there no friction? Well, if this was completely slippery, then the tension would pull it and it would move in this direction. What's the direction of the static friction force? It's in the direction opposite the direction that it would move if there were no friction. So we've now determined tension in this direction, static friction in this direction. Since this cart is not moving, those two forces must balance each other. They must have equal magnitudes and opposite directions. Since the cart is not moving in the vertical direction, the normal force and the gravitational force must also be of equal magnitude and opposite direction. So let's ask about how this static friction force behaves as we add more mass to the end of the string. So there's a greater mass. It's 50 grams. So we've increased the mass, we've increased the force down on this, increased the tension in the string, and therefore increased the force in this direction on the cart. The cart is still stationary. So by Newton's second law, all the forces must add up to zero. The net force must be zero. Therefore, the static friction force must be greater than it was before. If we move then to 100 grams, even greater static friction force to balance the greater tension force. And then at some point, you're going to add enough mass on the end of this string that the cart is going to start to slide. The point at which it starts to slide, now we'll talk more about in class, but that's where the static friction reaches its maximum possible value. It can't get any bigger, and then it gives up. And when static friction gives up, the cart accelerates, and another type of friction takes over. Static means stationary, means not moving. So static friction is what you get when objects are not moving, or in some cases not sliding against a surface. They're actually moving but not sliding, but in this case not moving. Once we've added enough mass to cause this cart to accelerate, then another type of friction is in operation. It's called kinetic friction, It also, in this case, it operates in exactly the opposite direction to the direction of motion. So that kinetic friction, tension is trying to accelerate the cart in this direction. Kinetic friction is trying to slow it down, and its role in life is to dissipate some energy and slow the cart down. It won't go as fast as it would without friction. So let me do the experiment now, starting with this mass pretty up near the top. And you can remember about how fast this is going when it reaches the pulley here. And then we'll do the whole experiment without kinetic friction. Okay, moving along pretty well. Turn the cart over now and ask how fast it's moving when it reaches the pulley. And I think you can see that it's moving considerably faster in the second case. In fact, we've got one of the labs is to study this problem, look at the forces, but this is a great introduction to static and kinetic friction.